the Mexico City right. Church with their families.
Amen.
But it's great to be family.
Pero el título es familia.
The title that's been given to me this morning.
El título que se me fue dado esta mañana.
The churches were strengthened in the faith.
Las iglesias estaban fortalecidas en la fe.
And grew in numbers.
Y crecieron en números.
Now it's usually my custom.
Es usualmente mi costumbre.
When I'm being translated.
Cuando soy traducido.
To only have the scriptures read in the translated language. However, since we have so many only English speakers here, in the first part of the sermon, I will be sharing it in English, and then Raúl will be reading it in Spanish. So the setting now, in the book of Acts chapter 2,
en Hechos capítulo 2,
different than the traditional date of 33 AD, is most likely 29 AD.
Quizá fue el 29 después de Cristo.
And we find the birth of the church
y vemos el nacimiento de la iglesia
after Peter's great gospel message.
Después del mensaje increíble de Pedro.
And in chapter 2, verse 40, we read,
y en el capítulo 2, versículo 40, vamos a leer,
with many other words, Peter bore them. And he pleaded with them, save yourselves from this corrupt generation. Those who accept this message were baptized. And about 3,000 were added to the number that day. They devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching, to the fellowship, to the breaking of bread, and to prayer.
Y con muchas otras razones les exhortaba insistentemente, sálvense de esta generación perversa. Así pues, los que recibieron su mensaje fueron bautizados. Y aquel día se unieron a la iglesia unas 3,000 personas. Se mantenían firmes en la enseñanza de los apóstoles, en la comunión, en el partimiento del pan y en la oración.
Amazing that first day, 3,000 were baptized into Christ.
Increíble que 3,000 fueron bautizados el primer día en Cristo.
And the Bible says immediately.
Y después,
they devoted themselves to apostles' teaching.
Ellos se enfocaban en la enseñanza de los apóstoles.
To the fellowship.
En la confraternidad.
To the breaking of the bread and the prayer.
El partir del pan y en la oración.
And this was just the start.
Y esto es el principio.
Then look what happens.
Después mire lo que pasa.
In verse 47.
En el versículo 47.
And the Lord added to their number daily those who were being saved.
Y cada día el Señor añadía al grupo los que iban siendo salvos.
Amazing. Now they're having daily baptisms there in
Jerusalem. Ahora tenemos bautismos diarios en Jerusalén.
A few months later, in chapter 4, verse 4,
algunos meses después, en capítulo 4, versículo 4,
but many heard the message believed, and the number of men grew to about 5,000.
Pero muchos de los que oyeron el mensaje creyeron, el número de estos llegaba a 5,000.
This wasn't a religion just for the women.
No era una religión solamente para las mujeres.
But the men were equally passionate.
Pero los hombres eran igualmente apasionados.
Because Jesus' call was revolutionary.
Porque el llamado de Jesús es revolucionario.
He came to change the world.
Él vino para salvar y mudar el mundo.
In Acts chapter 6, verse 1, we read.
En Hechos 6, versículo 1, leemos.
In those days, when the number of disciples was increasing.
En aquellos días, al aumentar el número de los discípulos.
Those days need to be these days.
Aquellos días tienen que ser estos días.
In every church, the number of disciples needs to be increasing.
En cada iglesia, el número de discípulos tiene que estar creciendo.
Well, how did they continue to increase?
Pero ¿cómo lo crecieron?
Look at chapter 5, verse 42.
Mira capítulo 5, versículo 42.
Day after day, in the temple courts, from house to house, they never stopped teaching and proclaiming the good news that Jesus is the Christ.
Y día tras día, en el templo y de casa en casa, no dejaban de enseñar y anunciar las buenas nuevas que Jesús es el Mesías.
This is incredible.
Esto es increíble.
Every disciple,
cada discípulo,
was preaching the word.
Estaba predicando la palabra.
Every day,
cada día.
If you are not preaching the word every day,
si tú no estás predicando la palabra cada día,
you are not walking in the footsteps of Jesus,
no estás caminando como Jesús,
nor his trusted apostles,
o sus apóstolos queridos.
As God's modern day disciples,
como discípulos modernos de Jesús,
we need to expect daily proclamation.
Tenemos que tener la expectativa de proclamar la palabra diariamente.
the word.
Que los apóstoles se enfocaran en la palabra y en la oración.
And so they delegate out the solving of the problems inside the church.
Para delegar los problemas que había adentro de la iglesia.
And then we read in verse 7.
Después leímos en el versículo 7.
The word of God spread. The number of the disciples in Jerusalem increased rapidly, and a large number of priests became obedient to the faith.
Y la palabra de Dios se difundía. El número de los discípulos aumentaba considerablemente en Jerusalén, e incluso muchos de los sacerdotes obedecían la fe.
When the evangelist devotes himself to prayer and the ministry of the word.
Cuando el evangelista se devota a la oración y al ministerio de la palabra.
The number of disciples is going to increase even more rapidly.
El número de discípulos va a crecer muy rápido.
And a note right here.
Y aquí vemos.
We find that a number of disciples in Jerusalem were formerly priests in the Jewish faith.
Muchos de los discípulos aquí eran sacerdotes en la fe judaica antes.
Sometimes we don't believe that, quote, leaders in other religions.
A veces no creemos que líderes en otras religiones
can become true disciples of Jesus.
Se pueden hacer discípulos de Jesús.
And yet I hold out to you the example of our brothers and sisters in Haiti.
Pero vemos el ejemplo de nuestros hermanos en Haití.
There in Haiti we start with one disciple.
En Haití comenzamos con un discípulo.
Who was a traditional mainline Church of Christ preacher.
Que era un predicador de la iglesia tradicional de Cristo.
Who got baptized in 2013 GLC as a true disciple.
Que se bautizó en el GLC de 2013 como discípulo verdadero.
He then went back.
Él fue, regresó.
He preached throughout Haiti.
Predicó en Haití.
We now have 200 disciples in Haiti. But here's the amazing thing. 25 of them are former preachers.
25 de ellos son antiguos predicadores.
In the traditional Church of Christ.
En la iglesia tradicional de Cristo.
As well as in the Pentecostal Church.
También en la iglesia pentecostal.
She said there are people that love God outside of the kingdom.
Hay personas que aman a Dios fuera del reino.
But we have got to believe that anyone can change if they love the truth.
Porque tenemos que creer que cualquier persona puede cambiar si ama la verdad.
Acts chapter 9. Acts chapter 9, verse 31.
Hechos 9:31.
This is after Saul has been converted.
Aquí se convirtió Saul.
Oh my goodness, the most radical zealot against the church has become a disciple of Jesus.
El más celoso contra la iglesia se convirtió en discípulo de Jesús.
Let me read.
Y leemos.
Then the church of Judea, Galilee, and Samaria enjoyed a time of peace. It was strengthened and encouraged by the Holy Faith, and it grew in numbers, living in the fear of the Lord.
Mientras tanto, la iglesia disfrutaba de paz, y a la vez que se consideraba en toda la Judea, Galilea y Samaria, pues vivía en el temor del Señor, y iba creciendo el número, fortalecida por el Espíritu Santo.
So right here the Bible says,
aquí la Biblia dice,
that the church has spread throughout all Israel.
Que la iglesia se esparció por Israel antiguo.
It has spread throughout Judea and Samaria.
Y Judea y Samaria también.
And the Bible says it was strengthened and encouraged by the Holy Spirit.
Dice que se fortalecía en el Espíritu Santo la iglesia.
And so it grew in numbers.
Creció en números.
We have critics who say, why do you guys talk about numbers? We talk about numbers because numbers is in the Bible. As a matter of fact, God has a whole book named Numbers. The people that don't want to talk about numbers, they're the people that don't have any numbers. But the word of God continued to increase and spread.
Pero la palabra de Dios seguía extendiéndose y difundiéndose.
Right here we find that the word of God is parallel to the church.
Aquí la palabra de Dios es paralela a la iglesia.
Which is parallel to a movement.
Que es paralelo al movimiento.
He doesn't talk about little autonomous churches growing.
Aquí no habla de iglesias autónomas creciendo.
He talks about the word of God.
La palabra de Dios.
Increasing and spreading.
Incrementaba y se esparcía.
And inferred right here is,
inferido aquí es,
they increased numerically,
crecían numéricamente,
and they spread geographically.
Se esparcían numéricamente, geográficamente.
This was in their day.
Esto fue en su día.
The modern day movement of God.
El movimiento moderno de Dios aquel día.
Go to Acts chapter 13.
Vamos a Hechos 13.
And right here, in the middle of what's called Paul's first missionary journey,
aquí en medio de la primer viaje misionero de Pablo,
we read a very interesting verse.
Vemos algo interesante.
In verse 49.
Versículo 49.
The word of the Lord spread to the whole region.
La palabra del Señor se difundía por toda la región.
This was a huge insight that Paul got.
Esto es algo increíble que Pablo hizo aquí.
He preached the biggest city there in Galatia.
Él predicó la ciudad más grande, Galacia.
The city of Antioch.
Y city de Antioquía.
And once he preached there,
y después que predicó ahí,
the word of God penetrated out from the influence of that city.
La palabra de Dios fue a otras ciudades afuera.
Into the whole region.
A toda la región.
Okay.
In chapter 14, verse 1.
14, versículo 1.
And Antonia and Paul and Barnabas went as usual in the Jewish synagogue. There they spoke so effectively that a great number of Jews and Gentiles believed.
En Iconio, Pablo y Bernabé entraron como de costumbre en la sinagoga judía y hablaron de tal manera que creyó una multitud de judíos y de griegos.
Here we understand a very important teaching.
Aquí aprendemos algo muy importante.
You can preach the word of God.
Puedes predicar la palabra de Dios.
And there will be few people coming to Christ.
Y pocas personas se convierten.
You've got to be discipled.
Tienes que ser discipulado.
In order to be effective.
Para ser efectivo.
And then you'll win large numbers to Christ like Paul and Barnabas.
Y después vas a ganar grandes números como Pablo y Bernabé.
Verse 21. Chapter 14.
Versículo 21, capítulo 14.
They preached the good news in that city and won a large number of disciples. Then they returned to Lystra, Iconium, and Antioch, strengthening the disciples and encouraging them to remain true to the faith. We must go through many hardships to enter the kingdom of God, they said.
Después de anunciar las buenas nuevas en aquella ciudad y de hacer muchos discípulos, Pablo y Bernabé regresaron a Lystra y Iconium y Antioquía, fortaleciendo a los discípulos y animándolos a perseverar en la fe. Es necesario pasar por muchas dificultades para entrar en el reino de Dios.
Paul had just been at Lystra.
Pablo ya estaba en Lystra.
And there at Lystra, he literally was stoned because of preaching the gospel.
Apedrejado en Lystra por predicar el evangelio.
But he gets back up,
pero se levanta,
goes back in the city and preaches one more day.
Entra en la ciudad de nuevo y predica otra vez.
Then he heads to Derby.
Y después se va a Derby.
And the Bible says he won a large number of disciples there.
Y la iglesia llegó un número grande de discípulos.
Then he went back to the other Galatian churches.
Y fue a la iglesia de Galacia.
Lystra, Iconium, and Antioch.
Lystra, Iconium, y
and those are the Galatian churches.
Y fueron iglesias en Galacia.
And he went back to strengthen them.
Y va a fortalecer esas iglesias.
And to encourage them.
Y animar las iglesias.
To remain true to the faith.
Para que se mantengan fieles a la fe.
Because he says we must go through many hardships to enter the kingdom of God.
Porque dijo, debemos pasar por muchas dificultades para entrar en el reino de Dios.
You know, that's why we have missions conferences.
Por eso tenemos conferencias de misiones.
It's because we need to be strengthened and encouraged.
Necesitamos ser animados y fortalecidos.
As I think many of you are aware of,
como saben muchos ustedes,
Elena and I handed over the City of Angels Church in Los Angeles.
La iglesia de Los Ángeles se la dimos a
to Tim and Leanne Kernan.
Tim y Leanne Kernan.
And they're doing an awesome job.
Están haciendo un trabajo increíble.
I mean, just last week, they had 16 baptisms.
16 baptisms.
But this allows Elena and myself to travel and to strengthen
y fortalecer
and encourage the disciples, particularly in missions conferences, because we must go through many hardships to enter the kingdom of God. And I pray that you're going to make decisions in the next 4 days to be strengthened and to do even more for Jesus Christ, even though there are going to be many hardships for the church.
Algunos de los judíos se convencieron y se unieron a Pablo y Silas, como también lo hicieron un buen número de mujeres prominentes y muchos griegos que adoraban a Dios.
Amen. This incredible large numbers come to Christ wherever the gospel's preached.
Grandes números vienen a Cristo donde se predica el evangelio.
But one of the keys to Paul's ministry is that from the first days, he converts prominent people. He converts opinion leaders. And one of the reasons our churches aren't multiplying as fast as they should, yes, we have numbers, but we're intimidated by prominent opinion leaders. And we should not be intimidated by anybody.
No podemos ser intimidados por nadie.
Because we are disciples of Jesus Christ. Come on, in verse 6, it was said of Paul and his companions,
dice Pablo los compañeros,
these men who have caused trouble all over the world have now come here.
Estos hombres han trastornado el mundo entero, han venido también acá.
But I like the Revised Standard Version.
Pregunta otra versión que dice.
It says, "These are the men."
Estos son los hombres
who have turned the world
que cambiaron el mundo
upside down for Jesus.
De cabeza para arriba para Jesús.
Yes, we're going to cause trouble.
Sí, vamos a causar problemas.
Because the gospel makes a difference.
Porque el evangelio hace una diferencia.
And we're calling people to make a decision.
Y llamamos personas a tomar decisiones.
Is Jesus the Christ?
Jesús es el Cristo.
And you believe we can change the world.
Y tú tienes que creer que puedes cambiar el mundo.
At the end of Acts,
al final de Hechos,
as Paul is in Rome now,
como Pablo está en Roma aquí,
we read this,
leemos esto,
in chapter 28, verse 21.
Capítulo 28, versículo 21.
They have replied, "We've not received any letters from Judea concerning you, and none of the brothers who have come here has reported that or said anything bad about you. But we want to hear what your views are, for we know that people everywhere are talking against this sect."
Nosotros no hemos recibido ninguna carta de Judea que tenga que ver contigo, le contestaron ellos. Ni ha llegado ninguno de los hermanos de allá con malos informes que haya hablado mal de ti. Pero queremos oír tu punto de vista, porque lo único que sabemos es que en todas partes se habla mal contra esa secta.
So right here, by the time Paul gets to Rome,
cuando Pablo llega a Roma,
we find that the criticism against the church,
la crítica contra la iglesia,
the criticism against God's movement,
las críticas contra el movimiento de Dios,
was that people were talking about it everywhere negatively.
Estamos hablando mal en todo lugar sobre la iglesia.
So while he's in prison there in Rome,
en cuanto está en la prisión ahí en Roma,
and it wasn't the imprisonment where he's in a dungeon,
y no en la prisión que estaba en un calabozo,
he's in a rented house,
está en una casa rentada,
he does have a Roman soldier holding him hostage,
tiene un soldado romano al lado de él,
but God has made him free to preach the gospel.
Pero Dios lo hizo libre para predicar el evangelio.
And during that time,
y durante ese tiempo,
most likely in about 62 A.D., he writes the book of Colossians.
Él escribe el libro de Colosenses.
Look what he says in the book of Colossians.
Vamos a ver.
Okay. In verse 23.
Capítulo,
chapter 1.
Capítulo 1, versículo 23.
This is the gospel that you heard, and has been proclaimed to every creature under heaven, and of which I, Paul, have become a servant.
Este es el evangelio que ustedes oyeron, y que ha sido proclamado en toda la creación debajo del cielo, y del que yo, Pablo, he llegado a ser servidor.
So by 62 AD,
en 62 después de Cristo,
33 years after the church began,
33 años después que la iglesia comenzó,
Paul writes,
Pablo escribe,
every creature under heaven,
toda criatura debajo del cielo,
has heard the gospel,
ha oído el evangelio.
That doesn't mean everybody became a Christian.
No implica que todo mundo sea cristiano.
That didn't mean everybody went to the study series. It wasn't invented then.
No estaba inventado en aquel tiempo.
It doesn't mean everybody liked the church.
No implica que todo el mundo gustaba la iglesia.
Quite out the opposite.
Lo opuesto.
It was because there was so much persecution.
Porque había tanta persecución.
They heard all about these troublemakers.
Oyeron de estos problemáticos.
Called disciples of Jesus Christ.
Discípulos de Jesús.
And so Paul can say,
y Pablo dice,
we have evangelized the nations.
Hemos evangelizado las naciones.
In this
en
generation.
Esta generación.
And that needs to be done again.
Otra vez.
Let's get back to the book of Acts.
Vamos a Hechos.
Since chapter 4,
capítulo 4,
Peter and John have been arrested for preaching.
Pablo y Pedro han arrestado por predicar.
They're standing before the Sanhedrin.
Están hablando con el Sanhedrin.
These are the leaders of, quote, modern day Israel.
Son los líderes de moderno de aquel tiempo de Israel.
And Peter lays out salvation is found in no one else but Jesus.
Pedro dice que la salvación solamente es en Jesús.
And then we read in verse 13.
Y después leemos en el versículo 13.
When the Sanhedrin saw the courage of Peter and John and realized they were unschooled, ordinary men, they were astonished. And they took note that these men had been with Jesus.
Los gobernantes al ver la osadía con que hablaban Pedro y Juan y al darse cuenta de que eran gente sin estudios ni preparación, quedaron asombrados y reconocieron que habían estado con Jesús.
Now right here,
aquí,
we find that the Sanhedrin's blown away.
El Sanhedrin está asombrado.
At the boldness,
a la osadía
of Peter and John,
de Pedro y Juan,
because they saw them,
porque los vieron,
as unschooled ordinary men,
como hombres sin preparación y ordinarios.
Now, I believe in the Spanish translation,
creo que en español dice,
it says something to the effect of unschooled with no preparation.
Que no tenía preparación.
But in the English, it says,
en inglés dice,
they were simply ordinary men.
Hombres ordinarios.
Yeah. We just read what happened in the first 33 years of the church.
Ya leímos lo que pasó en los primeros 33 años de la iglesia.
We just read what happened in the first 33 years of God's then modern day movement.
Acabamos de leer lo que pasó en los primeros 33 años del movimiento de Dios en aquel tiempo.
And so we come up with a very fundamental truth.
Y vemos una verdad fundamental.
The extraordinary,
lo extraordinario,
was accomplished by the ordinary.
Puede ser hecho por lo ordinario.
The extraordinary,
lo extraordinario,
the evangelization of the nations,
evangelizar naciones,
was accomplished by
fue
the ordinary.
Hecho por lo ordinario.
Is that awesome? So Jesus did it.
Sí,
and we're supposed to
Pero no tenemos que seguir sus pasos.
We gotta convert our families.
Jesús comisionó 70 otros.
Now some translations say 72.
Algunas traducciones dicen 72.
But it's almost absolutely 70.
Pero casi sabemos que es 70. Yeah.
Because you see, Jesus, for Jesus, numbers had a reason.
Para Jesús los números tenían una razón.
12 apostles.
Los apóstoles
represent a new kingdom.
Representan un nuevo reino.
There were the 12 tribes of Israel, or physical Israel.
Las 12 tribus de Israel física.
And there were the 12 apostles of spiritual Israel,
las 12
the church.
Tribus, los 12 apóstoles son
The 70
los 70
come down to human judgment
es un juicio humano,
and human leadership.
Y juicio y liderazgo humano.
The 70 elders around Moses.
Los 70 ancianos de Moisés.
And also in Genesis chapter 10.
Y en Génesis 10.
In that day.
En aquel día.
It had the table of all the nations of the world.
Había la lista de todas las naciones.
And had 70 nations.
Y tenía 70 naciones.
And so what Jesus is saying, with the picking up the 12,
lo que Jesús dice, cogiendo los 12,
he says, there's going to be a new kingdom.
Un nuevo reino.
When he picks the 70,
cuando los 70,
he says, it's going to go to all nations.
Ese reino va a llegar a todo el mundo.
And so, think about that.
Piensa bien.
You see, because Jesus commissioned the 70,
porque Jesús como nos comisionó los 70,
they too were apostles.
Ellos también eran apóstoles.
Anybody Jesus commissions an apostle.
Cualquier persona que Jesús comisiona es un apóstol.
Granted, the 12 were special.
Claro, los 12 eran especiales.
But the 70 were apostles.
Pero los 70 eran apóstoles.
Just like Jesus commissioned Paul.
Como Jesús comisionó.
Oh, you've been right here?
¿Están comiendo, hermanos?
So 120,
los 120
are the 12,
son
minus
12.
One. The women leaders,
mujeres,
Jesus' family,
la familia de Jesús,
and the 70 apostles.
Y los 70 apóstoles.
Is that an unbelievable group?
Qué grupo increíble.
Now go back to Acts chapter 2.
Ahora vamos a Hechos 2.
It says in verse 41,
dice en el versículo 41,
those who accepted his message were baptized.
Los que recibieron el mensaje fueron bautizados.
And 3,000 were added to the number.
Y 3,000 fueron agregados a ellos.
The number they were added to was the 120.
Ellos fueron agregados a los 120.
Look what it says in verse 42. They devote themselves to the apostles' teaching.
Se mantenían firmes a la enseñanza de los apóstoles.
To fellowship.
A la comunión.
To breaking bread and prayer.
Al partimiento del pan y la oración.
Notice there was a distinction.
No había distinción.
Between the 120 and the 3,000.
Entre los 120 y los 3,000.
It was just a simple thing.
Eran iguales.
So we can imply.
Podemos saber.
The 3,120.
Los 3,120
devote themselves to the apostles' teaching.
Ellos estaban totalmente comprometidos.
The 3,120 devote themselves to fellowship.
Estaban totalmente dedicados a la enseñanza.
The 3,120
los 3,120
devote themselves to breaking bread and prayer.
A la oración y a la comunión.
They were totally committed the day they were baptized.
Ellos estaban totalmente comprometidos el día que fueron bautizados.
Amen.
Is because they don't have a totally committed, sold-out membership.
Es porque la membresía no está totalmente comprometida.
The core of a church,
el núcleo de la iglesia,
needs to be its membership.
Tiene que ser su membresía,
not its mission team.
No un equipo misionero.
The membership,
la membresía,
needs to be totally indistinguishable.
Tiene que ser igual
from the mission team. Are you with me?
De cualquier equipo misionero.
No, I believe there are two basic reasons.
Yo creo que hay dos razones.
Why some of our churches they are not growing exponentially.
Porque algunas de nuestras iglesias no crecen exponencialmente.
Number one.
Número uno.
We are not hardline counting the cost.
No estamos contando los costos completamente.
We have got to be hardline when that young man, young woman, old man, or old woman is sitting there deciding to be a disciple of Jesus.
Cualquier persona que estudie la Biblia tengo que cortar los costos radicalmente.
We've got to talk about the tough doctrinal issues.
Tenemos que hablar de las cosas fuertes doctrinalmente.
Who's saved and who's lost?
¿Quién es salvo, quién es perdido?
Because you see, if they're fuzzy about who's saved and who's lost,
si están confundidos de quién es salvo y perdido,
and we say, hey, it's your purpose to seek and save the lost,
y decimos tu propósito buscar y salvar al perdido,
they are not going to be focused,
no van a estar enfocados,
because they're unsure who's lost and who's saved.
No saben quién es salvo o perdido.
We need to be hardline. dating relationships. A disciple of Jesus needs to cut them off.
Amen.
Because he loves Jesus. For she loves Jesus more than this relationship. We need to talk about parents and family. Very often they set themselves against us. Because they don't understand the radical change. And you well know that Jesus' family thought he was out of his mind. But he took a stand. And at the end, he converted all of his family. And say, listen, are you willing to go home to your home country and preach?
Vamos,
if they're unwilling to go, they cannot be baptized. Because a disciple is willing to do anything, go anywhere, and give up everything for Jesus. Strong leaders.
Hemos visto líderes que parecían ser fuertes.
fall because the man fails to have a disciple time with his wife. Let me tell you something. If you're not getting discipled, bad things are going to happen. You know, we were blessed to be in Manila for the inaugural service. On June 7th, just last year. And it was incredible. We had 49 in the remnant group, 9 on the mission team, and we had 306 at the inaugural service. But at the end of the inaugural service, I'm trying to go after all the visitors. And I see this older couple standing kind of stiff over at the side. So I go on over. And I find out their names. Simple and Jenny Castro. And I find out that they're from our former fellowship. But after I try to hug them, they're very stiff. I said, do you have any questions about the new movement? They go, yeah, we have lots of them. I said, okay, let's get together tomorrow for Bible study. So we got the leaders of Manila Church and them together. And we just laid out the core convictions. That everybody's got to be a disciple in God's church. And they got to be in discipling relationships.
Amen.
That we believe in a central leadership of the central leader.
Creemos en una liderazgo central como líder central.
And we believe it's a command.
Y creemos que es un mandamiento.
To take the gospel to all nations.
Llevar el evangelio a todas las naciones.
In this generation.
En esta generación.
Amen.
He started to cry.
Él comenzó a llorar.
He says, I have got so much to repent of.
Wow, tengo que me arrepentir de tantas cosas.
He says, can I be restored on Sunday?
¿Puedo retornarme el domingo?
So on Sunday, they get up in front of the church, as is our custom.
El domingo, por la iglesia, se pone frente a la iglesia.
And he gets up and he starts weeping.
Y él comienza a llorar.
He says, you know something?
¿Sabes?
When our former fellowship,
cuando nuestro antiguo confraternidad,
abandoned discipling,
abandonó el discipulado,
he says, I will take full responsibility here.
Yo tomo responsabilidad 100%.
But my life became hell.
Pero mi vida se hizo un infierno.
He says, it got so bad.
Se hizo tan malo.
Because I have an anger problem.
Porque yo tengo un problema con el enojo.
That I held up a loaded gun to my wife's head.
Que le apunté una pistola a mi esposa en la cabeza.
In front of my four daughters.
Al frente de mis cuatro hijas.
I had nowhere to confess my sins.
No tenía ningún lugar donde confesar mi pecado.
No one to talk to.
A nadie podía hablar.
This man I am now so inspired.
Pero estoy inspirado.
To be back in a church.
Estar de vuelta en
la iglesia. That believes in discipling.
Amen.
Jenny get restored that day.
Simplo and Jenny se restauran ese domingo.
And they brought their four daughters for the first time that Sunday.
Y trajeron las cuatro hijas al servicio ese domingo.
Now their four daughters' names.
Los nombres de las cuatro hijas son.
Are Candy.
Candy.
Cake.
Cake.
Chocolate kisses.
Besos con chocolate.
Or chokis. And Carmel.
Caramelo.
They were so nervous.
Estaban tan nerviosas.
Because they've been so poisoned by our former fellowship. And so I invited them, since they were all teenagers, to go out to eat. That's often how you get to a teenager's heart.
Yeah!
And at dinner, they started having a lot of questions.
Wow.
2 weeks later,
dos semanas después,
the three older girls,
las tres
that were disciples,
que eran discípulas,
they placed membership.
Se hicieron miembros,
and the youngest one, Carmel,
la más joven,
was baptized in
the church.
Upon meditation,
wow.
They gave Elena and me this picture. This is the Castro family. And they are all united in Christ. Because now they're in a church that practices discipling. Amen. You know, in any church that practices discipling, There's got to be an ever-increasing number of baptisms.
Tiene que haber un número que incrementa de bautismos.
I was so inspired by Carlos's prayer in January.
Me inspiró mucho la oración de Carlos en enero.
Yeah. For those that don't know,
para los que no saben,
Carlos and Lucy lead the church here in Mexico City.
Ellos lideran la iglesia aquí en México.
And in January, had about 50 disciples.
En enero tenía como 50 discípulos.
And Carlos on January 1st goes,
y Carlos oró en el primero de enero,
God,
Dios,
please give us 10 additions in January.
Danos 10 ediciones en enero.
Well, that's a lot of faith.
Mucha fe.
You only have 50 disciples.
Y 50 discípulos.
Well, it got to be the very last day of January.
Llegó al último día de enero.
January 31st.
Enero 31.
And on that Sunday,
y ese domingo,
they had their 9th edition.
Tuvieron su novena edición.
And Carlos kind of thought to himself,
Carlos pensó,
wait, that's pretty cranking.
Bueno.
I mean, 9 editions?
9 ediciones?
Okay, it's not 10, but
no es 10, pero
9 is
pero,
great.
Pero bueno, increíble.
Well, about 7 o'clock that night,
a las 7 de la noche esa tarde,
he gets a call from Hector Gomez.
Recibe una llamada de Hector Gomez.
He says, hey, bro, I've got this guy that wants to study.
Hermano, tengo una, este hermano que quiere, este hombre que
his name's Alberto. Carlos gets with them.
Carlos vuelve con él.
And lo and behold, Alberto's near the end of the studies.
Y Alberto está terminando los estudios.
And at 11:45 p.m.
A las 11:45 de la noche.
On the very last day of January.
El último día de enero.
Alberto was baptized into Christ. Baptisms than Boston had its first year.
primer año.
And God gave us 104 baptisms. By the year 2011,
para el año 2011,
again, 4 years later,
4 años después,
we had daily baptisms in Los Angeles. And the daily baptisms continue to this day. And so what is the goal for Mexico City? Daily baptism.
Come on!
What is the goal for San Diego? Daily baptism.
Come on!
What is the goal for San Pablo? Daily baptism. What is the goal for Bogota? Daily baptism. My second point.
Yeah.
Extraordinary campus ministries.
Amen.
Ministerios universitarios extraordinarios.
I will make this a bit abbreviated.
Voy a abreviar un poquito.
A few weeks ago,
algunas semanas atrás,
it occurred to me,
pensé,
I wonder what age
¿qué edad?
The 12 apostles really were.
Apóstoles.
I mean, you see different paintings.
Vemos pinturas.
But how old were they really?
Pero ¿qué edad tuvieron los
apóstoles? So I started researching it and studying out the scriptures.
Entonces empecé a estudiar las escrituras.
And remember back in Acts 4:13,
y acuérdate que en Hechos 4:13,
we find that Sanhedrin,
vemos que el Sanhedrin
looked at John and Peter,
Juan y Pedro,
and saw them to be unschooled ordinary men.
Y eran hombres ordinarios sin estudios.
Now, interestingly,
lo interesante es,
the word ordinary in the Greek right there,
la palabra ordinario en el griego es,
is the Greek word idiote.
Idiote.
Where we get the English word idiot.
Sacamos la palabra en inglés.
So, the Sanhedrin is looking at Peter, John, the apostles.
He
says, man, these guys are unschooled idiots. And yet,
sin embargo,
they saw boldness,
vieron la osadía,
and they knew they'd been Jesus.
Y que estaban con Jesús.
We also have another thing that's very difficult to reconcile. Scholars,
los estudiosos,
look at particularly John's writing
ven los escritos de Juan
in the New Testament,
en el Nuevo Testamento,
and call it some of the finest Koine Greek ever written.
Y hablan que es uno de los griegos más
vivos
que se escribió.
How did this happen?
¿Cómo lo hizo Juan?
Well, let's review some scriptures that we all know well.
Vamos,
vamos a
ver
algunas escrituras que sabemos muy bien.
In Luke 6:12-13,
en Lucas 6:12-13,
Jesus prays all night.
Jesús ora toda la noche.
Calls all of his disciples to him.
Llama a todos los discípulos para él.
And he chooses 12.
Y escoge los 12.
Okay. Now here's where we kind of lose who Jesus is.
Y aquí donde pierde quién es Jesús.
In that day,
en ese día,
Jesus was known as
Jesús era conocido como
a rabbi.
Rabí.
He was even called that.
Él lo le llamaban eso.
So then we understand in Mark 3:13.
Y vemos en Marcos 3:13.
The Bible says,
la Biblia dice,
he called those he wanted.
Llamó aquellos que él quería. Yeah.
In Luke 3:23,
en Lucas 3:23,
we find that Jesus was about 30 years old when he was baptized.
Vemos que Jesús tenía más o menos 30 años cuando se bautizó.
And began his ministry.
Y comenzó su ministerio.
That's an important note.
Es algo importante.
Because Jewish tradition has
porque la tradición judía dice
that a rabbi begins to call
empieza a llamar
young men to follow him.
A los hombres jóvenes para seguir a él
when they're 30 years old.
Cuando eran 30 años, cuando llegaban.
Interestingly,
lo interesante es,
in that day, in the first century,
día, en el primer siglo,
the formal schooling for boys,
la escuela formal para los niños,
ended when they were 12 to 15 years old.
Acababa cuando tenían entre 12 a 15 años.
At that time, they began to learn a trade.
Y después de eso, aprendían un trabajo.
However,
sin embargo,
the best of the best,
los mejores de los mejores,
were chosen by rabbis.
Escogidos por rabis.
To follow them,
para seguir a ellos,
so they too could become rabbis.
Para que ellos también se hicieran rabis.
Let's do a little edge check.
Vamos a pensar.
The disciple we know the most about is John.
El discípulo que sabemos lo más es Juan.
Most people believe that he dies in 100 A.D.
La mayoría cree que Juan murió en el año 100 después de Cristo.
Most believe he was born in 8 A.D.
Algunos creen que nació en el 8 después de Cristo.
Since Jesus' real ministry was about 25 to 29 A.D.,
como el ministerio de Jesús fue del 29 al 23,
It checks out. He'd have been 17 years old.
Era como 17 años.
Now here's something that's very interesting. Let's read now Matthew 17, 24 through 27.
Vamos a Mateo 27. What's it again?
Chapter 17, 24 through 27.
Mateo 17, 24 al 27. La Biblia dice, cuando Jesús y sus discípulos llegaron a Capernaum, los que cobraban el impuesto del templo se acercaron a Pedro y le preguntaron, ¿su maestro no paga el impuesto del templo? Sí, lo paga, respondió Pedro. Al entrar Pedro en la casa, se adelantó Jesús a preguntarle, ¿tú qué opinas, Simón? ¿Los reyes de la tierra, a quiénes cobran tributos e impuestos? ¿A los suyos o a los demás? A los demás, contestó Pedro. Entonces los suyos están exentos, dijo Jesús. Pero para no escandalizar a esta gente, vete al lago y echa al suelo. Saca el primer pez que pique, abre la boca y encontrarás una moneda. Tómala y dásela a ellos por mi impuesto y por el tuyo.
Now that's a pretty cool way to raise money, isn't it? But notice.
Pero mira,
Jesus is in the company of all of his disciples.
Jesús está con todos sus discípulos, dice aquí.
The tax collectors come.
Los cobradores de impuestos vienen.
To get the temple tax.
Para recibir el impuesto del templo.
But notice the dialogue is only between Peter and Jesus.
Pero el diálogo es solamente de Pedro y Jesús.
And Jesus says, Peter, go fishing.
Jesús dice, Pedro pesca.
And get the temple tax for you and for me.
Y ahí vas a coger el impuesto del templo para mí y para ti.
Here's what's fascinating.
Esto es lo fascinante.
In Exodus chapter 30,
en Éxodo 30,
verses 13 through 14,
versículo 13 al 14,
the temple tax was only to be paid by
el impuesto del templo solo lo pagaba
a man who was 20 years old or older.
20 años o más.
What does this imply?
¿Qué implica esto?
Peter was the oldest.
Pedro era más viejo.
He was the only disciple that had to pay the tax.
Pero el único discípulo que tenía que pagar el impuesto.
And all the other ones were younger than that.
Los otros eran más jóvenes que eso.
Another fascinating teaching
algo fascinante
that reinforces that is this.
Es esto.
In Mark chapter 1, verse 30,
en Marcos 1, 30,
we find that Peter's mother-in-law is healed.
La suegra de Pedro es sanada.
But what's the big deal about that?
¿Qué implica eso?
Means he was married.
Estaba casado, Pedro.
None of the other apostles at this point are said to be married.
Ninguno de los apóstoles en aquel tiempo
era casado. But because the Jewish tradition of that day was that when you were 18 years old, then you would be given a wife. Are you seeing what I'm saying right here? So implied in that, Peter was the only one that was 18. At the beginning of the ministry. So let's summarize right here. Jesus chooses
Jesús escoge,
out of all of his disciples,
de todos sus discípulos,
the best of the best.
Los mejores de los mejores.
He chooses
él escoge,
and some of them did already have professions.
Y algunos tenían una profesión.
Fishing.
Pescar.
Tax collecting.
Cobrar impuestos.
But they would have started to learn those professions
ellos comenzaron a aprender esa profesión
as young or 12 or 15 years
entre
old.
12 y 15 años.
He takes the best of the best
él toma los mejores de los mejores
to school them
para enseñarles
to be with them
para que esté con él.
And isn't it interesting
y no es interesante
that implied in several places
que implicaba en varios lugares
Peter is the oldest of
Pedro
the apostles
es el más viejo de los apóstoles
and the leader of the
y el
apostles.
Líder de los apóstoles.
Okay, now where is Jesus' ministry as a rabbi unique?
¿Por qué el ministerio de Jesús como rabí era único?
Turn to Luke chapter 8.
Vamos a Lucas, capítulo 8.
Vamos, kid.
In Luke 8, we read in verses 1 through 3.
En Lucas 8, vamos a leer en el versículo 1 al 3. Después de esto, Jesús estuvo recorriendo los pueblos y las aldeas, proclamando las buenas nuevas del reino de Dios. Lo acompañaban los doce y también algunas mujeres que habían sido sanadas de espíritus malignos y de enfermedades. María, a la que llamaban Magdalena, y de que le habían salido siete demonios. Juana, esposa de Cusa, el administrador de Herodes, y Susana, y muchas más que lo ayudaban con sus propios recursos.
This is incredible.
Increíble.
All discipling books written by men,
todos los libros fueron escritos por hombres,
all of them talk about,
todos hablan
12 apostles.
Pero habla de los apóstoles.
But the inner three apostles.
Pero los tres más cercanos apóstoles.
Peter, James, and John.
Pedro, Juan, y Santiago.
So, right here, though,
aquí vemos,
we have Jesus' inner circle of women.
Vemos el círculo concéntrico pequeño de mujeres.
So we have a couple things unique already.
Unas cosas únicas acá.
Number one, Jesus was a rabbi.
Jesús era un rabí.
Who had women sit at his feet.
Que tenía mujeres sentado a sus pies.
Oh, now we understand the passage about Martha and Mary.
Ahora tenemos el pasaje de Marta y María.
Martha's out there in the kitchen worried and upset Marta about many things.
La cocina.
But Mary is seated at Jesus'
María
feet.
Está a los pies de Jesús.
What a great privilege to learn from the rabbi, the master.
El maestro.
Okay.
Now we understand
ahora tenemos
that his plan for discipleship
que el plan discipulado
is the same for men and for women.
Es lo mismo para los hombres que para las mujeres.
That's why we don't need a female Jesus.
Por eso no necesitas un Jesús femenino.
One Jesus is good enough.
Un Jesús es suficiente.
Amen.
He trained the men
los hombres,
and the women were trained at the same occasion.
Y las mujeres tienen entrenado al mismo tiempo.
Yes, there's a little distance.
Sí, hay una distancia.
But isn't it interesting in all of the places where women are listed,
en todos los lugares que donde listan mujeres,
Mary Magdalene's always listed first.
María Magdalena siempre la primera.
Just like Peter's always listed
como
first.
Pedro era el primero.
So there was a woman leader.
Pero eso implica que había una
and
mujer
we understand
líder.
Discipleship is not just for singles.
El discipulado no solamente para los solteros.
But there was a married woman.
Pero había una mujer casada aquí también.
So you can be a disciple and be
puede
a married woman.
Discípulo ser una mujer casada.
So what are we understanding right here?
¿Qué tenemos aquí?
Jesus was a rabbi.
Jesús era un rabí.
The schooling
la escuela
that went past normal schooling,
que pasa la escuela normal,
which we call college today,
que llamamos universidad hoy,
was done in the Jewish system
en el sistema judío
by rabbis.
Era hecho por los rabíes.
The rabbis would choose the best of the best.
Los rabíes escogían los mejores de los mejores.
Jesus chose not only the best of the best guys, but gals too.
Jesús escogió no solamente lo mejor de los mejores hombres, pero también
so how could John someday come up with the best cornet writing of all time?
¿Cómo que Juan escribió el griego más pulido de ese tiempo?
He had been with Jesus.
Estaba con Jesús.
At the University of Jesus.
En la Universidad de Jesús.
That is the first campus ministry.
Ese fue el primer sistema universitario.
Do you need to understand how important campus ministry is?
Tiene que entender qué importante es el ministerio universitario.
People are young, they're idealistic.
Cuando la gente son jóvenes, son idealistas.
They have no baggage in their lives.
No tienen problemas del pasado.
And they can marry the right kind of person.
La persona correcta.
That's why we've got to have great campus
ministry. Por eso necesitamos ministerios universitarios increíbles.
I was so impressed to be in San Pablo.
Me estuve impresionado estar en San Pablo.
They have an incredible ministry there.
Increíble.
They have about 150 disciples.
Tienen más o menos 150 discípulos.
And about one third of the church,
la iglesia,
about 50 disciples are campus students.
Yeah.
And it was so awesome
y fue increíble
to be able to see these outstanding young men
hombres jóvenes,
and outstanding young women.
Mujeres jóvenes.
Many of them come from one of the best universities in Central South America.
Algunos vienen de una de las mejores universidades de Centro Sudamérica.
And to be able to hear them preach.
Y escuchar a ellos predicar.
Brothers like Danilo,
Kyle,
Juan Carlos, Luca, Vinny.
Vinny.
And then there was a guy that didn't go to any college. That's Flavio.
Que Flavio que
but he was a kingdom kid, so that's a lot of education.
Amen.
And there were incredible sisters.
Carol,
Malu, Barista, and Gabby.
Gabby.
I mean, it's incredible. You see, oh my gosh.
There's more.
Brazil is going to get
evangelized.
Yeah.
And these disciples,
discípulos,
they're not stopping at the borders of Brazil.
No van a parar en la,
they're going to go throughout South America.
America.
Yeah. Yeah. Now, I was really excited
mucho.
That this past month
que ese último mes,
in Manila, they
en
started
Manila.
ICC in Manila.
ICCM, Manila.
Yeah.
And order to have an ICCM, you have to have a master's from the ICCM. And so we have ICCM Manila, ICCM Portland, of course ICCM
Los Angeles,
but starting next month we're going to have ICCM San Francisco. So, we have ICCM hats. This is one of the original ones, and so on the back of the hat is
es en Los Ángeles, atrás.
Los Angeles.
Ese sí en Los Ángeles.
Next month,
el próximo mes,
we're having hats made.
Vamos a hacer
that we're in ICC in
São Paulo.
And I want to see
yo quiero ver
hats that say ICC in DF.
ICC in DF.
Now that's going to change.
Eso va a cambiar.
Because we're going to have a sold out base.
Una base totalmente comprometida.
And they're going to multiply.
That's right.
Cárcel.
And Sunday we're going to have daily baptisms. And not only Unam, but Ponte, they can come out for you with the
word. Oh, yeah.
Our last point.
Nuestro último punto.
Extraordinary campaign.
Campañas extraordinarias.
What was the extraordinary campaign?
¿Cuál era la campaña extraordinaria?
The evangelization of the nations in this generation.
La evangelización del mundo en esta generación.
Now, you should have been passed out.
Quizás tienes ahí
a map
of
Paul's missionary journeys.
De los viajes misioneros de Pablo.
And remember the passage in Acts 13:49?
¿Te acuerdas del pasaje en Hechos 13:49?
Where Paul learned when he went to Pisidian Antioch.
Que cuando Pablo fue a Pisidia en Antioch.
When he built the church there.
Construyó la iglesia
the
ahí.
Word of God went through the whole region.
La palabra de Dios llegó a toda la región.
And so we see on the map.
Aquí vemos en el mapa.
On the western side of what's called Asia.
Parte del oeste de Asia.
The city of Troas.
La ciudad de Troas.
Put your finger there and then go to Acts chapter 16.
Pon tu dedo ahí y ve a Hechos capítulo 16.
Paul had been going through Galatia.
Pablo fue a Galacia.
See where Galatia is. Strengthening all the old churches.
Él estaba fortaleciendo las iglesias.
They were having daily baptisms.
Bautismo diario.
And then through a course of events.
Y después por eventos.
He gets to Troas.
Él va a Troas.
And there he has a dream. Let's read about it in verses 9 and 10.
Vamos a leer en el versículo 9 y 10. Capítulo 16 dice. Durante la noche Pablo tuvo una visión en la que ve un hombre de Macedonia puesto de pie y le rogaba, pasa a Macedonia y ayúdanos. Después de que Pablo tuvo la visión, enseguida nos preparamos para partir hacia Macedonia, convencidos de que Dios nos había llamado a anunciar el Evangelio a los macedonios.
Wow, Paul's here in Troas.
Aquí está Troas, Pablo.
He has this dream of a Macedonian.
Tiene esta visión de un hombre de Macedonia.
Saying, come over and help us.
Ven y ayúdenos.
Well, what was the bottom line of this dream?
¿Cuál era el punto del sueño?
Up to this point,
punto,
all of Paul's efforts for the gospel
de Pablo por el
had only been in the continent of Asia.
En el continente de la Asia.
Macedonia lies in the continent
Macedonia
of Europe.
Está en Europa.
What was God doing right here?
¿Qué estaba haciendo Dios aquí?
He was stretching Paul's vision.
Estaba esticando la visión de Pablo.
To go beyond where he was comfortable in Asia.
Para que no se estaba cómodo en Asia.
And go into all the world,
including Europe. En Europa.
Does your vision need to be stretched?
¿Tu visión necesita ser estirada?
Does it need to be stretched beyond America?
¿Necesita ser estirada más que América?
I mean, you got to ask yourself,
tiene que preguntarte,
if you were born in a Latin family, why?
¿Por qué?
Yeah, you know, I appreciate the fact that Adam Cepeda,
yo aprecio que Adam Cepeda
come this August,
en agosto,
is going to be leaving the comforts of America,
va a dejar la comunidad de América
and going down to preach the word in São Paulo, Brazil. We got ready at once to leave.
Nosotros nos preparamos para predicar.
Concluding that God had called us
to
preach the gospel to them.
La palabra de Dios.
Now notice the we right here
nota que dice nosotros.
Means it's Luke.
Implicando fue Lucas.
So Luke joins Paul
Lucas
there in Troas.
Pablo Troas.
Now if you look at your map,
si mira el mapa,
they have it incorrectly labeled right here.
No lo dice bien aquí, pero bueno.
Luke joins Paul.
Lucas se une a Pablo.
Guys, don't ever look at secular material
no
as the final
material secular para tomar todas tus decisiones.
Always go by the Bible.
Vamos
here.
So
we understand here that Luke and Timothy,
Lucas y Timoteo,
and Silas,
y Silas,
they didn't get the dream. But when Paul told about the dream, they got ready at once, concluding that God has called them to preach the gospel. So when your evangelist comes to you.
Cuando tu hermanito te dice,
when your mom's ministry leader comes to you,
la consejera buena te
with
dice,
the dream that God has given them,
el sueño que Dios le dio a él,
you need to get ready at once
al momento,
to go to the place that God has sent you away with it, man.
Zarpando de Troas, navegamos directamente a Samotracia y al día siguiente a Neápolis. De allí fuimos a Filipos, que es una colonia romana y la ciudad principal de ese distrito de Macedonia. En esa ciudad nos quedamos varios días.
This is awesome. Look at your map.
Mira el mapa.
Now, the second missionary journey of Paul is in purple.
La segunda viaje misionero está en...
So they sail the first day to the little island of Samothrace.
Fueron a Samothrace.
Then they sail on to Neapolis.
Después fueron a Neapolis.
And you say, well, but why didn't they stop in Neapolis to start a church?
¿Por qué no pararon en Neapolis para construir una iglesia?
Why did they go 9 miles to Philippi?
¿Por qué fueron 9 millas a Filipos?
Why did they go 14 kilometers to Philippi?
14 kilómetros a Filipos.
Well, we're given the answer right here.
La respuesta.
It says Philippi was the leading city of that district of Macedonia.
De Macedonia.
Paul and started to place the church in Philippi. The word of God's going to the whole region.
La palabra llega a toda la región.
And pretty soon Neapolis is going to get planted.
Neapolis también va a ser implantada después.
Go to chapter 17.
Vamos al capítulo 17.
Verse 1.
Versículo 1. Atravesando Anfípolis, Anfípolis y Apolonia, Pablo y Silas llegaron a Tesalónica, donde había una sinagoga de los judíos.
Wow, now Paul travels from Philippi
de Pablo a Filipos
to Thessalonica.
A Tesalónica.
Well, this is interesting because that's about 100 miles.
Es como 100 millas.
About 160 kilometers.
160 kilómetros.
But he bypasses Amphipolis and Apollonia.
Y Apollonia, salta esas dos ciudades.
Why?
¿Por qué?
Because Thessalonica,
porque Tesalónica
is the capital of Macedonia.
Capital de Macedonia.
You get a church planted in the capital,
planted la ciudad de la capital,
it's going to get to the smaller cities of Apollonia.
And
well, he has to, the next place he has to go fast.
Después tiene que ir rápido.
That's Berea.
Berea.
It's about 45 miles.
45 kilómetros, millas.
I guess about 70 kilometers.
70 kilómetros.
So why does he go to Berea?
Porque va a Berea.
Because it's the old capital
porque
of Macedonia.
Es la capital antigua de Macedonia.
Then there's more persecution.
Después viene más persecución.
And the Bible says that he goes to the coast.
Y la Biblia dice que va a la costa.
And so implied is he sails all the way down to Athens.
Va en barco a Atenas.
That trip,
ese viaje,
would have been 500 miles.
500 millas.
800 kilometers.
800 kilómetros.
Weren't there a lot of other cities there?
No había tantas ciudades antes.
Why go to Athens?
¿Por qué ir a Atenas?
It was the intellectual capital of the entire world. Then he goes to Corinth. Only about 50 miles from Athens.
50 millas de Atenas.
Why does he go to Corinth?
Porque va a Corinto.
It's the capital of the Roman province of Achaia.
De la provincia romana de Achaia.
As a matter of fact, by this time it's about 250,000 people.
A mí, como un cuarto millón vivían ahí.
Where's the last stop on this missionary journey?
¿Cuál fue el último punto que fue?
Ephesus.
Efesios.
Ephesus is over in Asia.
Efesios está en Asia.
At this time, Ephesus was the fourth largest city in the
era
world.
La cuarta ciudad más grande del mundo.
Number one, of course, was Rome.
Primero fue Roma.
Number two was Alexandria in Asia.
Número dos, Alexandria en
Number Egipto. Three was Antioch, not Pisidian Antioch, but Syrian Antioch. And the fourth largest city in the world was Ephesus.
Ciudad del mundo fue Efesios.
It had about 300,000 people.
Tenía como 300,000 personas.
He wanted to plant the church there.
Él quería implantar la iglesia.
And the Bible says in Acts 19,
y la Biblia dice en Hechos 19,
verses 9 and 10,
versículos 9 y 10,
he goes to the campus,
él va a la universidad,
the lecturer of Tyrannus, preaches for 2 years,
predica por 2 años,
and the Bible says all of Asia
heard the word of the Lord.
So we see right here,
aquí vemos,
there's a pattern.
Hay un patrón.
As a matter of fact, he eventually gets to Rome.
Él llega eventualmente a Roma.
Why get to Rome?
Porque ir a Roma?
It's the largest city in the world.
La ciudad más grande del mundo.
A million people.
Un millón de personas.
And if you get to Rome,
y si llegas a Roma,
you can say that its influence is the whole
su
world.
Influencia va a llegar a todo
the gospel.
El mundo por el evangelio.
Now take up, if you will, the Crown of Thorns Project sheet.
Ahora saca el plan de corona de espinas.
This is not a new plan.
No es un plano nuevo.
basically Jesus' plan for evangelizing the nations.
Evangelizar las naciones.
We start out with Acts 1:8. This is Jesus' vision.
Comenzamos con Hechos 1:8. Vamos a ver ahí, por favor. Pero cuando venga el Espíritu Santo sobre ustedes, recibirán poder y serán mis testigos, tanto en Jerusalén como en toda Judea y Samaria y hasta los confines de la tierra.
So Jesus started in Jerusalem,
comenzaron en Jerusalén,
then go to all Israel, Judea and Samaria,
then in Judea, Samaria,
and then to the ends of the earth.
Después al final de, al,
we have the same plan.
Tenemos el mismo plan.
God's modern day Jerusalem, Los Angeles.
La moderna Jerusalén, Los Angeles.
God's modern day Judea and Samaria,
Judea y Samaria moderna,
United States and Canada.
Estados Unidos y Canadá.
The ends of the earth,
los confines de la tierra,
still the ends of the earth.
Es igual los confines de la tierra.
But like Paul,
como Pablo,
we have picked out,
hemos escogido,
some of the most influential cities of the world.
Algunas de las ciudades más influyentes del mundo.
Now we're guided by remnant groups a bit.
Estamos guiados por grupos remanentes.
But still we selected 12
hemos
cities.
Hemos escogido 12 ciudades.
And we laid this plan out in 2009.
Hicimos este plan en el 2009.
And by that time, the Santiago Church was
Santiago
up and running. Amen.
Amen.
In 2010, we planted
Londres. Londres.
2011, São Paulo, Brazil. In 2012, Mexico City, Paris. 2014, Sydney. At the end of that year, Chennai, India. Now they just celebrated their first year anniversary. They had 101 additions that first year. 94 baptisms.
Wow.
And 7 restorations. Then, just last year, we planted Moscow. I was just there 3 weeks ago for their anniversary service. In the first year of Moscow, Russia. And everything's changed. And they're quite opposed to Americans.
No, les gustan americanos.
As a matter of fact, Elena went there just recently.
Elena fue ahí también, también.
One of the non-Christian Russians attacked her and hit her on the back.
Le dio un puño en la espalda.
Because they saw and heard her speaking in English.
Que ella estaba hablando inglés.
And knew she was an American.
Y sabía que era americana.
And yet the brothers and sisters over there, there's no such thing as a Russian Christian,
no hay, rusos cristianos,
or American Christians,
o cristianos americanos.
We're all global disciples in God's one movement.
Globales.
In the very first year,
primer año,
they had 77 editions,
77 ediciones,
41 baptisms,
41 bautismos,
24 restorations,
24 restauraciones,
12 place memberships,
y 12 integraciones.
Then, look at this, last year in Manila, 2015,
el último año en Manila,
in less than 9 months,
meses,
God has given them 90 baptisms.
90 bautismos.
Five of them last Sunday.
Cinco domingo pasado.
At one campus.
Una universidad.
RTU.
RTU.
They've had 18 restorations.
18
9 place memberships.
Nueve
integraciones
del movimiento Tivo.
In less than 9 months, they've had 117
additions.
Wow. God is good. Lord willing, in May, we're sending out Lagos, Nigeria. At the TLC, we're sending out Dubai. And then we already have the mission team in Sydney with 12 Chinese disciples to be sent to Hong Kong next year. Amazingly, in 11 years, the Holy Spirit would have gone to all 12 cities that we laid out by faith we could get to.
Para llegar.
And now we have Tratador's projects for each of the world sectors. So the Bible says, yes, the churches grew.
Las iglesias crecieron.
But they grew daily.
Pero crecieron diariamente.
When we look back to 2007, and the 42 disciples from Portland that planted the City of Angels Church,
y los 42 discípulos que plantaron la iglesia en Los Ángeles,
in 8.5 years,
en 8.5 años,
they have multiplied to over 4,000 disciples,
4,000 discípulos,
in 65 churches,
en 65
in 32 nations,
en 32 naciones,
on all 6 populated continents of the world.
Del mundo.
I say to you,
te digo yo,
this is not a movement of men.
Este no es un movimiento de hombres.
It is the modern day movement.